G'day one and all, I'm Southpaw Racer. This super serious track guide takes place in the newest country to get a Formula One Grand Prix, Qatar. The Australian Grand Prix was cancelled for the second season in a row. Dark times for us Aussies. At least Dan got a win this year. Anyway, the gaping chasm left by Albert Park was filled by the Losail International Circuit. This track will be familiar to all you two-wheeled fans out there. It's a fixture of the modern MotoGP calendar, but the race just gone was the only time, for now, that Formula One will race here. As such, there aren't many fully realized, complete versions of the track available for modern sims, but a basic rendition does exist for Assetto Corsa in a few different versions. The link to the one I'm using, which I think is the best one, is in the description. Time for the lap. Let's go. Have you ever wondered what the first turns at Bahrain would be like if they approached the event horizon of a black hole and got stretched to kingdom come by the gravitational forces? Well, here's your answer. After the long front straight, turn one is the best passing spot on the whole lap, and even then, it's a narrow window. There's barely any braking zone at all before the front end just gives up. Then you have to try and build up speed again and switch back for another giant hairpin? Are these hairpins? Argue about it in the comments. When do you start accelerating? Doesn't matter what your answer is, it's wrong. Fight the over, under, whatever steer and ruin your exit as you squeeze through the flat out turn 3. Try not to spin. A simple start to the lap, but oh boy, it's about to get more complicated. Fortunately, this straight is just long enough for you to prepare. Do some Kegel exercises, this is gonna be rough. Tip it in fourth gear. It's actually proper fun, this duo of corners. At least the first is, if you're out of your depth like me. The turns are too close together to really treat as separate corners, but far enough apart that you can't just turn in once and be done with it. The way you're supposed to attack this section is to give it a little throttle in between the corners and lift off again for turn 5. But you're driving a Formula One type car, on a computer, sitting still. You might find it difficult to tell how fast you're really accelerating. There's also the matter of turn 5 being a little tighter than turn 4, but not in a way that's obvious until you find yourself slithering off the road, the tyres turning into mac and cheese. Okay, onwards and upwards, I guess. Turn 6, the slowest corner on the circuit. Our favourite type, the second gear hairpin.
Yeah.
Alright, great stuff! Yeah, you did the thing! Memes! Got 'em! Shit. Anyway, yeah, it's a hairpin. What more can I say? You brake hard about 75 meters before it, wind on as much steering as necessary, and feed onto the power like you'd approach a family argument at a wake. Not that it's gonna matter, because the exit curb has its own ideas about how your lap should go. Another short straight follows, after which you encounter turn 1 again? Wow, that was a quick lap. Unless I'm doomed to loop back over and over, never seeing the start-finish line again. Oh no, 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 no. Am I back in that dimensional bullshit storyline I half committed to? Is this my punishment for not releasing more slightly serious showcases? Oh, no, 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 calm down. We're only halfway around. And yeah, okay, turn 7 is a little different from turn 1, but for me, the technique is largely the same. Fire it in, straight to the inside, pick up the throttle too early, and compromise the upcoming turns. Carbon copy! Stick to the left to open up this right-hander, just lifting a touch, and weave across the track into another heavy braking zone, which you should have started preparing for about 5 seconds ago. Now, let me think. Medium speed corner into near flat out kink that leads right into a hairpin. The effects of aero disturbance are felt in the extreme here, so an interesting opportunity in any other racing series just turns into another part of the waiting game until the DRS zone. Your next step is to forget that turn 10 is a much faster hairpin than turn 6 and delay getting on the power. This means you carry much less momentum and self-confidence through turn 11. That's a shame, because the next 3 turns can sense performance anxiety. Before the Grand Prix, I heard and read that these corners could be flat out in the real world. Well, it's true for the first two at least. It's exhilarating when you get it right, of course it is, but there are a series of similar geometric kinks in the same direction, with the curbs being your only real clues as to where to go. Familiar territory for a few 21st century tracks. The empty, samey surroundings mean their subtle differences escape me, in much the same way my talent does. It's a 1-2-3 punch of when do I turn in? Okay, that wasn't it. Oh, I gotta lift, don't I? Too late, and curb consumed. Ah, great. Another straight. I love having an opportunity to dwell on my errors. At least we're basically at the end of the lap now. Turn 15 is the last of the oh god what do I do corners. It requires a lift, a downshift, and a prayer. If you somehow get through here without spearing off at warp speed, you have my respect, as well as my sympathies for what you must have gone through to get to that point. One turn to go, thank whatever deity may be out there. It's yet another that feels like turn one at first glance, but it's not as sharp as it seems, so in goes the car, fourth gear, and by the time you're at the other end of the corner, you've realised you haven't started accelerating yet. If the exit curb doesn't get you... ouch. Sheepishly trundle down the straight to the line, and reflect on how good this track can be, on your own, in slower, less aero-sensitive cars. The race wasn't horrible, and this circuit might have had the certification to host F1 since it was built, but we can't get away from the fact it was designed for bikes. I suppose the four-wheeled crowd only had to deal with it this year. The Qatar Grand Prix is skipping 2022, and then returning long-term at what is presumed to be a new street circuit. That's right, they signed a 10-year deal to race at a track that doesn't exist yet. Which actually happens a lot. Oh well, with this region's recent history of using migrant labour in forced, grueling, and deadly working conditions, at least the new track shouldn't take long to build, right? Now, this track model's looking a little bare bones. Would you mind helping me put up this We Races 1 banner? Then after that, we can help out with the Aramco signs. This video was made possible by the wonderful people listed here, as well as the super serious supporters on my car: Adam Miller, Callum Crayston, Ira Felberg, Jack Moore, Jay Kennedy, Michael Hollinshead, Pub With No Beer, The Original Sticks, Thomas Clarendon Blair, Thomas Dandridge, and Tom Hins. Every patron gets to vote on the next Super Serious Track Guide at the start of every month. If you're interested in supporting me and having a say on what track I roast next, become a patron today at patreon.com/southpawracer. Thank you for your support, and I'll see you at the first corner.